Good morning. Eugene Kelly. I actually drove here from Brooksville, Florida to speak on behalf of the Florida Native Plant Society. I'm a member of the board of directors representing 5,000 members, about 37 chapters, including the local chapters in Osceola and Orange County, the Tarflower. And I find it hard to speak after so many eloquent speakers and so much passion was represented. I wanted to speak for the plants. Strangely enough, the person who preceded me did at least give a mention to the plants. There are a number of endangered plant species out there, several endangered orchid species. They're every bit as dependent on conserved habitat as scrub jays and fox squirrels. They're every bit as dependent on long-term management that will include the use of prescribed fire. I find myself wanting to take a slightly different approach here since so many have spoken before me. And I think I see your decision as, in some respect, a kind of cost-benefit analysis. You have to take a very broad-scale look at this issue. And so I would say some of the costs are easily measured. How much did it cost to buy this land? How much has been invested in managing it over these years to turn it into the pristine natural area that it is today? Easily measured in dollars and cents. There are some benefits that I don't think you can measure that way. I would ask you to think about replacement value. You simply can't replace split oak. You don't have any more split oaks, and every acre you take away is an acre that you can't put back. I'd ask you to think about appreciation and value. Certainly it's worth more in dollars and cents than it was when it was purchased decades ago. And we can foresee a time, not in the too distant future, where split oak will very likely be an island of green in a sea of asphalt and steel and brick and mortar. And this road that we're talking about will ironically expedite that result. So how will these lands appreciate in value when 50 years from now it is that island of green? Will your grandchildren be able to take their grandchildren for a walk in the woods where they might see their first scrub jay, their first fox squirrel, their first pine lily in flower? You're one link in a chain of decision makers. Split oak was created decades ago by people who had some vision and foresight, and they created something special. There will be other decision makers after you, and the role you play is going to be every bit as pivotal as the role played by the people who gave us split oak in the first place. Will you be setting the stage for those decision makers to decide, well, it's just the path of least resistance?
Mr. Kelly,
conservation lands have been treated like that before.
That is your time, sir. But thank you for the drive over, and thank you for being here today.
Please stay out of space.